Welcome to our Joget DX8 app building introduction and quick tutorial. With Joget DX8, creating apps for both desktop and mobile devices is fast and easy, with an intuitive drag-and-drop visual interface. For the quick tutorial, we will create a full-fledged app to handle customer service requests in just minutes. Let's begin. In the Joget App Center, we will log in as the default administrator. The default administrator's username and password are both admin. The App Center displays a grid of published apps. On the bottom right here is the admin bar, where we can manage apps, users, monitoring, and system settings. Let's click on All Apps. This opens an overlay that shows all the published and unpublished apps. Published apps will display any available UIs on the App Center, whereas unpublished ones will simply be inaccessible and hidden from end users. To close the overlay window, click on the X button located at the top right corner. As an administrator, we have the privilege to create and modify apps. The three ways to do so are to design a new app, import an existing app, or download an app directly from the Joget Marketplace. In this case, let's get started on our new app, the Customer Service Request app. Click on Design New App. We are going to create a whole new app. As you can see here, we can either create a blank app, create an app from a template, or clone an existing app. In our case, we will create a blank app. Key in an app ID and a descriptive name, then click on Save. Good job! Now we have the base for the app, shown here in an App Composer view. In the Builders tab, we have Form Builder, List Builder, UI Builder, and Process Builder that shows the forms, lists, UIs, and processes in the app. The Process Builder shows the workflow processes designed for the app. Do note that it is not mandatory for an app to have a process. You can create each of these components manually, or use the App Generator feature to generate the required components automatically based on a template, which we will demonstrate soon. The Versions tab shows the list of app versions and indicates the currently published version with a green tick. In this case, our app is version 1 but yet to be published, hence the green tick is still not visible. App designers can create and publish new versions of the app. The app can also be exported to be deployed on any other Joget server. The Settings tab allows you to configure the app properties, delegate app designer roles, and make Git configurations. We have other tabs on the left side of the App Composer. Notes tab allows app designers to take down notes regarding the app. App Variable tab stores the commonly used parameters of the app and can be retrieved using hash variable. App Messages tab allows app designers to customize values in the app in different locales. Resources tab stores commonly used files of the app. Plugin Default Properties tab allows pre-selecting and configuring the plugins you intend to use in the app. Performance tab or Application Performance Management, which is commonly known as APM, monitors the app performance in runtime and alerts can be configured for various metrics such as an error. Logs tab shows the server log for messages and errors present in this app. This is useful for app designers and developers to quickly troubleshoot issues for the current app. All right, let's head back to the Builders tab to create a new form. We will start by creating a request form for customers to submit their request information. Let's fill in the relevant form details. After clicking on Save, we will be automatically redirected to the form builder of our newly created form. Here, we can see the form builder of the customer request form. On the left side of the form builder, you can see the palette which contains the available form elements. And at the middle of the form builder, we have the form canvas. When you click on any elements, in this case the section element, its properties panel will appear and you can configure the properties. Now, let's try changing this section label to a more meaningful value. Different form elements have different properties that can be configured. After performing the label change, click on Apply Change and you will see the changes made to the label of the section. Now that we have configured our section, let's add a few basic form elements to the form canvas for our request form. You can simply drag and drop form elements from the palette into the form canvas. Let's drag in a text field element. Similarly to how we opened the section properties panel earlier, now click on the text field element to configure the text field properties. Let's set this text field element as the title of the request. We can use the ID suggested as it has a good naming convention. A form can contain one or more sections, and each section may contain one or more columns. You can add more sections into the form using the plus button and shift sections around the form by dragging it to your preferred position. We can delete an element by clicking on the trash icon. At any time, you may preview the form by clicking on the Preview tab. Let's see. We are actually lacking many more important form fields. Now, we shall continue editing the form. We can use the search palette feature to find form elements. Let's add another text area element to the form. This will be the description of the request form. Once you have finished designing the form, click on the Save button. You will receive confirmation that the form is saved. Now, it is optional in this tutorial to add more form elements to the request form. Pause this video temporarily if you wish to do so. Fantastic! We are done with our request form. Available in the Joget DX8 Enterprise Edition, the App Generator is a feature that greatly accelerates the app building duration. To use the App Generator, click on the Generate App button on the top right corner of the Form Builder. Do make sure that the form is saved first. The App Generator will offer options to generate a list, CRUD, and a couple of built-in process templates. You can click on the Advanced Generation button to fine-tune the generator properties if you wish to. Check the first two options to generate a list and a CRUD. And since we also require an assignment process to handle customer service requests, we will also check the assignment process. Click on Generate and we are good to go. Once the generation is complete, you can safely close the app generator. Let's return to the App Composer page. Coming back to the App Composer view, we should see a number of auto-generated list, UI, and an assignment process. In addition, since auto-generated apps are also automatically published, instantly you will be able to launch the app in runtime from both the App Composer or the Joget App Center. We will launch our new app from the App Center. This is the automatically generated app UI, and here is the request form that we created. Let's try to submit a request to start the assignment process. All right. Looks great so far. Additionally, the app that we created is also mobile ready. As you can see, the mobile app center is in responsive mode. You can log in on mobile Joget like how you did on the PC Joget. Now you can see the customer service request app on mobile Joget. Awesome. Our app is now complete. In just a few minutes, we have successfully built a full-fledged enterprise app. As an administrator and app designer, let's see how we can easily maintain or customize our app. The Quick Edit mode is a feature that allows administrators to quickly identify forms, lists, and UI menus directly from the front-end UIs, and even navigate to their respective builders. If you are logged in as an administrator, you will see a minimized admin bar on the right, with the option to toggle Quick Edit mode. Once Quick Edit mode is enabled, elements within the UI page are highlighted with Quick Edit buttons. Clicking on the Quick Edit button will launch the respective builder in a new window. Let's open up the request form by clicking this button here. Now that we are instantly back into our request form, we can try editing our existing form. We will set the title text field as mandatory, as the title of a request form is a required information. First, go to Advanced Options. Set the validator property to a basic validator. Now, you can see additional configurations for the selected basic validator plugin. For the basic validator configuration, check the mandatory property option. The title text field now ensures that end users can only submit the form when a title of the request form is stated. Once you are done editing, remember to save the form. Now back to our app in runtime, reload the page and you will see the immediate changes in the form. The red asterisk determines that the title field is a required field. Last but not least, for an even faster way to get sample or template apps, you can go to the Joget Marketplace, which is an enterprise app store for Joget apps and plugins. In the App Center, click on the Download from Marketplace button. To download apps, you will first need to sign up for a free account. Pause the video here if you wish to create a free account. All right, we have signed into the Joget Marketplace. Let's see if there is an app similar to what we built previously. Excellent. We can find a service help desk app. Let's click on this app to find out more about it. All right, this seems suitable. Now on the top right here, click on the install button to install the app directly into Joget. The app will be seamlessly downloaded and installed for you. Refresh the page and it will appear as a published app in the Joget App Center. From here onwards, you can simply use the app as it is, or even customize the app if required. Good job! We are done with the Joget DX8 app building introduction and quick tutorial. Thanks for watching.